This is your WGBW Daily News Roundup for the Talk of Green Bay, 97.9 FM and 1590 AM.
Civic Media News. I'm Terry Bell. Here's what Wisconsin needs to know. Wisconsin voters are approving two new amendments to the state constitution after yesterday's primary. The First Amendment will ban private grants to help local offices run their elections. The second will limit who should be allowed to serve as a poll worker. That means clerks can no longer ask for, accept, or use private money, and only election officials designated by law can work the polls. Donald Trump is the winner of the Republican presidential primary in Wisconsin. He also campaigned in Green Bay yesterday.
A vote for Trump is a vote to save Wisconsin, and it's a vote to save your country. This country is finished if we don't win this election.
President Biden won the Democratic primary. He campaigns in Madison on Monday. President Biden may be in trouble. More than 47,000 Wisconsin Democrats voted uninstructed in yesterday's primary. Anthony Chergosky teaches political science at UW-LaCrosse. He tells Wisconsin Eye that critics of Biden's Gaza policy are sending a clear message.
Biden cannot take their support for granted. They might have enough numbers where if they sit out the 2024 general election, it could cost Biden the election in Wisconsin.
Wisconsin is one of a handful of states expected to decide the election. The worst should be over after a powerful storm dumped several inches of wet, heavy snow on much of Wisconsin yesterday and overnight. Snowy and windy weather is forecast to last into tomorrow. I'm Terry Bell, Civic Media News. Here's what you need to know closer to home.
For WGBW News, I'm Lisa Hale. One of the more interesting races in the presidential primary ballot was the contest for the mayor of Menasha. 26-year-old Austin R. Hammond becomes Menasha's youngest ever mayor by defeating Rebecca Nichols. Don Merks, who has served as the city's mayor for the past 16 years, did not seek re-election. Other mayoral races saw Steve Youngworth keep his seat as AMRO mayor with 68% of the vote. The De Pere School District referendum to exceed the revenue limit by $4.75 million passed yesterday. Lux-Burg-Casco School District requested to exceed the revenue limit by $1.8 million for 3 years for operational expenses. That referendum also passed. Freedom School District referendum for $62.5 million for building and facility improvements at the middle high school passed with 61% of the voters saying yes. The $15 million referendum for the Seymour School District passed by a very narrow margin. Only 32 more voters said yes than no to the referendum to cover operational and maintenance costs at the schools. And the Shawano School District referendum for $54.5 million for facility improvements, renovations, and additions across the school district failed by a margin of only 75 votes. Concerns about the legality of a get-out-the-vote campaign caused the event to be canceled yesterday. Several organizations in Brown County joined together to offer free rides to the polls, free food, an open bar, and prizes for social media influencers who got the most people to vote. Brown County DA David Loss wrote a letter to the organization specifically citing the social media competition as a possible statute violation. The groups did cancel the event, but didn't mention the letter from Loss. An 18-year-old Green Bay man pleads not guilty and not guilty by reason of mental disease or defect to charges of second-degree sexual assault of a child, false imprisonment, and attempted sexual assault of a child. Mauricio Paulus is accused of assaulting or trying to assault girls at a Green Bay hotel in January on the 20th and on the 25th. According to the criminal complaint, Paulus admitted to the acts. Law enforcement departments across Brown County are partnering with the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, and Explosives and with the Green Bay Area Crime Stoppers to prevent crime related to the illegal purchase of firearms. To do so, they have created tactical mats that are placed on the counters of businesses as shopkeepers show guns to potential buyers. The mats warn that purchasing a gun for someone who can't is illegal and can result in up to 15 years in prison and a $25,000 fine. UW Green Bay is hosting its first ever Giving Day today, says Madeline Von Grohl, the Advancement and Development Director.
One day, big fundraising sprint there at UW Green Bay. All gifts up to $200,000 will be matched. Thanks, Kathy and Larry Trinkler.
The 24-hour Giving Day event collects funds for athletics, the Widener Center, need-based scholarships, academics, and the Fund for Excellence. For information, search uwgb.edu, Giving Day. And that's what you need to know. I'm Lisa Hale, WGBW News.
A win on opening day. Now Mike Clemens with sports. The Brewers kicked off their home game season with a 3-2 win over the Minnesota Twins. There was a home run by Christian Yelich, good pitching, and new third baseman Oliver Dunn with a SportsCenter top 10 catch that had him looking like Superman on Bally Sports.
Liner caught! Put a cape on him!
Couple of steps, a dive, and able to keep it in the gloves. Big defense.
Oliver Dunn after the game.
We were playing down the line, and I knew that more than likely the ball was going to be at me or that way. So I think I was anticipating a little bit being that way because we were guarding the double. But it was one of those ones you just hope to react the right way when the play happens.
NBA, the Bucks lose another road game, this time to the Wizards. 117-113.
I don't know. I just think they outplayed us. Give them credit. I thought they were faster, quicker. I don't know if we took them light or not, to be honest. I just thought they outplayed us.
That's Bucks head coach Doc Rivers. With sports, I'm Mike Clemens.
On your entertainment beat, I'm Pete Schwabe. There will be very little community building on the set of the movie Community. Actor Joel McHale says he doubts Chevy Chase will be allowed on the set, and even if he was, he probably wouldn't be interested anyway. The New York Post reports McHale says Chase left the show during season 4 after the two were involved in a physical altercation. Chase reportedly didn't think the show was funny enough, to which the rest of the cast basically said, then leave. So he did. First, he tried to strangle Elmo on The View, and now he's facing jail time for helping someone stay hydrated in a voting line. Both of the aforementioned are TV crimes committed by Curb Your Enthusiasm creator Larry David. David totally committed to the gag by taking a Trump-style mugshot and getting Georgia politicians in on the gag. Elmo eventually dropped any criminal charge against David, but is pursuing a civil suit. If only acting desperate on a podcast made you a better actor. Tori Spelling informed her husband of 18 years and the father of her 5 children, Dean McDermott, that she is filing for divorce. Normally, that's not news because no one remembers Tori Spelling, which is why she decided to inform her husband of her intentions on her podcast while he was at work. Spelling even told her listeners, "He's at work, you guys. This sucks." Spelling elaborated on the podcast, saying their relationship has never been the same since they had kids. Well, duh. Taylor Swift has been crowned Artist of the Year at the 12th Annual iHeartRadio Awards. Swift accepted the award that was voted on by fans in a pre-recorded speech where she teased there were some exciting things coming up. That's probably true given that Swifties get excited when they see Taylor watching a game they know nothing about. Swift also won for Artist of the Year and Tour of the Year. Her new album, The Tortured Poets Department, drops April 18th. Kira Sedgwick told The View that the secret to keeping her marriage to Kevin Bacon fresh is that the two stay curious about each other. The couple met on the set of Lemon Sky in the 80s. The actress said part of staying curious is that you have to hide the fact that you've known each other for 35 years. So the best way to stay curious would be to divorce, live apart for 5 years, and then go on a date. Can you imagine how strong that would make your marriage? Sometimes it's hard for criminals to adjust to life on the outside after doing hard time. The New York Post reports that ex-con and actor Felicity Huffman is assimilating and has gotten a role on Criminal Minds. Huffman spent 11 days hard time for trying to get her half-wit kids into a good college by having someone else take their SATs. Several people were sentenced to jail time in what has become known as the Varsity Blues scandal, including actress Lori Loughlin, whose kids are also not too bright. For more showbiz fun, tune in to Nightlight with me, Pete Schwabe, every night between 7 and 9 p.m. on the Civic Media Radio Network.
It is going to be windy with scattered off and on snow through the day today. We may only get a couple more inches of accumulation, but wind will be from the north gusting to between 30 and 40, even up to 45 at times, and that will create some issues. 37 today, more light rain and snow tonight, 33 tomorrow, rain and snow ending 41. I'm meteorologist Sean Cable. Outside now, it's 33.
That's your WGBW Daily News Roundup from Civic Media. Subscribe to this podcast on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you find your podcasts. Find more news at wgbw.fm.